Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom Shop here. Okay, well, in one of my previous videos, namely the marked for death compensated high capper pistol project that I did fairly recently, well, I happened to mention about the fact that I was thinking of doing the Punisher 1911, now that I knew that the compensator idea worked. Well, here's the pictures of them that I've managed to download. They're not very good. Actually, online, the only fairly decent pictures that you can download are of the Western Arms version, which has some inaccuracies, so I didn't really want to go exactly to that design. Anyway, I've watched the film numerous times now, practically worn out my DVD copy, using the pause button and so forth. Done some screen grabs and whatever. And I've managed to work out exactly what needs to be done. And this is as far as I've got so far. Starting with the frame, it's just a standard 1911 A1 Tokyo Marie plastic frame. All I've done is ground off the tangs. By the way, you can use the MEU frame, because I believe, now looking a bit harder at some of the frame grabs that I've got, that the front strap is actually checkered. It's been checkered for grip, but it's hard to tell on the film. It's very, very hard. So I've had one of these in my spares box, so I thought I'd use it. Yeah, so as I say, I've ground down the tangs on the frame to accept an MEU style grip safety, as per the one in the film. I've tried polishing this one up. It's not turned out exactly as I wanted to, but I've yet to use the auto sole polish on it. All I've done is just ground it down for the moment using a polishing wheel on my Dremel. And it doesn't really come up that well. I may even consider using the silver Garda grip safety. I've had experience of those in the past and not been too happy with them. That's what's put me off of using them. So, but I'll maybe give them another go. Okay, moving on to the rest of the furniture. This is a standard MEU. Actually, no, it's not. It's a stainless steel Garda, I believe, or one of those anyway. I think it is Garda steel, solid steel replacement ambi-thumb safety. It's the King's type, which is the type that is used on the Punisher pistol. As you can see, it's the King's type. So I've used that. This was actually donated by a friend. Thanks, Chris, very much appreciated. A long while back, actually, in a box of bits that I bought off of him. So it's finally coming useful. So yes, again, polished that up, but it hasn't come out exactly as I wanted it to. So I may consider swapping that out eventually for a Garda King's Ambi thumb safety, the silver one. Now then, this is a standard Tokyo Marie 4.3 Commander style hammer. I prefer using these because the hole, as I've mentioned I think previously, the hole in these is more accurate to a real steel one as compared to the Tanya Cobra one, which has a slightly smaller hole for some reason, I don't know why. So that one's been polished up. For some unknown reason, these hammers seem to polish up better than what other parts do. I don't know why that is. Maybe it's a different kind of pop metal, I don't know, but these always seem to polish up nicely, and they don't dull so quick as the other parts do. Anyway, okay, so that's those few parts that I've done so far. Now then, when it comes to the slide itself, there's going to be a few additional points obviously done to this. Firstly, the forward cocking serrations, they're going to be cut in eventually, which are identical to the rear ones, i.e. straight, not slanted or anything like that. The rear sight, there will be a Novak cut or a 4.3 cut for the rear sight. The front sight, this original one will be cut off and a new one will be pinned and glued on the front there, as I've done on numerous other projects. Now then, with regards to the lowering and flaring of the ejection port, that's not required. The one in the film only is lowered ever so slightly, but it's not actually flared out at the rear. I don't know why this is. For some reason I've checked and rechecked and it is exactly as that. It's not as per the Western Arms, which is, as I say, Western Arms have got inaccuracies. They've got a flared port, which is wrong. It's lowered, yes, but not flared. So if you are thinking of doing one of these and you want it exactly as the film, then don't flare it, just lower it. Okay, so that's enough on the slide. Yes, one other thing with regards to the slide. These markings will be filled, but myself, I may leave them, actually, because it is a Colt gun. And it will save me having to get it re-engraved with a Colt Mark IV Series 80, which I believe those pistols were in the film. So I may just leave it, I don't know. I'll see how it goes on that front. Again, it's up to the individual. Now, with regards to the guide rod plug, the original guide rod plug that's in the M1911, I've taken out, and I'm replacing it with the 5.1 guide rod plug. Now, you will notice, if I show you, that it's shorter by a good deal, by easily 2mm. I have mentioned this on other videos, that the 5.1 slide apron, this section here, the front section, is longer on the single stack slides by Tokyo Marine than what it is on the 5.1 slides. Hence, the guide rod plug for the 5.1 matches the 5.1 slide, and the guide rod plug the 1911 matches the 1911. You can swap them round, but obviously, as you see, it's going to be shorter. But on this project, doesn't matter, because the guide rod will be straight through there. There's no need for the plug hole, for the stopped plug, so this one can be used. Okay, so that's that. Now then, along with the guide rods, coming back to these, I made up, or had a friend actually make up some guide rods for us. Or cut us some anyway, out of steel rod. Now what I do, or should I say what my friend does, is take a washer, ordinary washer, that is the same or pretty much the same diameter as this rod, and all he does is he just slots it on the end, and he I believe it's bronzed onto the end of the guide rod, of the metal steel rod. It's then a small pin or drill hole is put in, and a pin is put through to help with its structure, so it stays on, you know, for sure. So even if the bronzing gives way, the pin won't. Then all I do is, once I get it back, is I grind it down to the exact same diameter as what it's required to be, drill out the rear end so that it will fit on a 1911 hop unit, which has got this little nub that sticks out on the end. The 5.1 hasn't, so if you can't drill out the end or you don't want to, you can always leave that out. But I find that drilling out the end and using the 1911 or MEU hop units make the guide rod more stable, because it's located, the pin is located into that hole. Whether you're using an aftermarket one or, like me, a homemade one, it does make it more stable. With regards to the 5.1, the frame is slightly different, so it's less encumbersome, and it allows the 5.1 guide rod to rattle around a bit more, whereas the 1911 single stack frames, they seem to push it up more or like constrict its movement. So it's always best to have the 1911 or MEU hop unit when using a single stack frame, or even using the 1911 slide on the high capper frame. It pays to use this setup more so than the 5.1 setup. It just makes it more stable, and I've found that works on all pistol setups, whether it's 5.1s, high cappers, 4.3s, 1911s, MEUs, whatever. It's always better to have that locating hole. It just makes the guide rod more stable. Now then, after all that, and getting the guide rod made up, which would have been perfect for this, I found that I couldn't really use it. Now, to help you guys out there, what I mean is when this is actually put in to the slide, I'll come to how I did this in a minute, i.e. the compensator. This, in order to get this out, you need to be able to move it around in order to slide it out past the hop unit. Well, once it's in place, there's no way to do that, especially if the guide rod tube is quite narrow. There is no way to do it. So, unfortunately, I had to bin this idea. Well, not bin it, but not use it for this project. So, I sent off to Elite Shooting Centre, and good old Mike, he sent me one in return, which is an LCT one. Well, actually, it's not. It's a bit of a mishmash of parts. It's, I believe, this is a 9-ball one. But then saying that, 9-ball don't have the very chromed guide rods. They have these type, which is like a plain silvery guide rod. But I might be wrong. But I've only used one 9-ball in the past, and it was silvered both ends. But as you can see, there are no holes in either section in order to tighten against. It uses a special screw method, which as it starts getting nearer to its tightening point, it gets tighter and tighter in its screw thread. Yeah, it's okay, it works, but I don't like them. I prefer the LCT ones, which have got holes at either side of the join. It allows you to tighten them up. It's a lot easier to disassemble for when you're disassembling your pistol. So I'd recommend the LCTs. But unfortunately, but also quirkily fortunate for me, when Mike sent me this one, although I did ask for the LCT, this one, although it's slightly wrong, actually is going to work. Because if it was a standard length guide rod, it would only reach to the back end of the compensator. It wouldn't go inside it. It would only reach to the back end. But being as this is like a made-up job, it actually goes the full length slightly into the compensator housing, which means that it's easier to remove. So even if I don't strip this down, it will go in and out a lot easier. But my aim is to drill two small pilot holes into each section so that I can tighten against one another when I come to strip the pistol in future. Anyway, that's by the by. So yes, although it's wrong, it's right. Strange as it may seem. But there you go. So that's guide rods. Bit of info there for you if you ever think of doing this project or another project similar to it. Is in order to get your guide rod in and out from a compensator, you either have to make sure that the guide rod hole on the compensator itself is quite large, or that you can remove the guide rod tube, plunger, whatever you want to call it, from the compensator itself, so that you can then slide the guide rod out without it being in there. Or, as I say, use a split one so that you can just literally take it apart, slide the rod out, and then just take the spring and the guide rod out, or the one end of it. Hope I haven't confused you guys with all of that, but it does make sense when you start using it and looking at it practically. Okay, this is the compensator, pardon me. It's right, where do I start? Okay, the barrel itself, or the barrel chamber, is actually a plastic ABS barrel chamber from a high kappa 5.1. I've done exactly what I've done on the Marked for Death pistol, or should I say the Federal Ordnance PSP pistol, and on my AMT. I've cut the barrel chamber off, but left a slight sleeve, and sleeved over the top a section of old barrel, plastic barrel, from, I believe it was a 1911, and just slid it on. Now, it's all to do with measurement. In order to make, oh, by the way, this end of the barrel, as you can see, is a 5.1 flared ball barrel, again ABS plastic, again sleeved over this. So if you can imagine, that one goes up inside this sleeve, this goes up inside this sleeve, so it's literally one inside the other, boom, like that. That way, when this is moving backwards and forwards, it's not rubbing against it too much and won't give it the excuse to blow the end out. It will hold it in position. Not that it should touch the barrels anyway, it's inside its own little tube. Now then, with regards to the compensator itself, this is a front end from a 1911 A1 slide. It's had the chin cutouts, namely these, done away with, ground them out exactly like I did on the AMT, no different whatsoever. There's small holes either side which I will eventually fill. As I say, this is an intermediary starting point. The barrel from the 5.1 very carefully was super glued into position whilst it was lined up in the slide, so that way you can line this through with the chin cutouts on the slide itself, but be very, very careful that the super glue doesn't glue the whole lot together. So keep it slightly apart but in line. I used a piece of card and just put a piece of card around there so that when it had all glued, I could just rip the card off, sand it down, and it didn't notice too much. Again, I used Zappa Gap super glue. Very, very good glue. I know I don't get any commission for advertising this glue, but it is very, very good. I will also be using my faithful MMD putty. Again, I don't get any commission from this. Maybe I should write to them. Anyway, yeah, it's good putty. It's good filler. Works well. Far better than the other stuff that I used to use, Milliput. That used to crack quite a bit, but that stuff doesn't. Anyway, so eventually these ends will all be filled, and the front end will be filled. Now then, as you can tell, or you should be able to work out, that barrel only goes as far as there. That's as far as I glued it in. I had to sleeve it, which I hope I've still got some here. Yes, I have. With this, which is a very, very, very fine plastic card. You can pick it up from most hobby specialists or model shops. It's very, very thin. It's literally like, well, wafer thin. But it's exceptionally handy because these barrels, obviously, slide in and out of the front of the slide without touching the edges, or at least hardly at all. So I had to sleeve the end of the barrel so that it was wedged into the front of this compensator, now compensator, slide front, and then glued it. So this was wrapped around the end. I removed the chroming because otherwise it won't stick to that. But funnily enough, the glue that I used wasn't super glue at first. It was this, which is Mr. Cement S. It's by Mr. Hobby. It's a Japanese glue. It's a model glue used for plastic kits. Use this first. For some reason, this seems to eat into ABS plastic just the same as it does ordinary polystyrene plastic that you use for model kits and what this plastic card is made out of. So I used that first. I doubt if other hobby glues will do the same. The reason being, these Japanese cements are specialist cements. They are very, very good. At least that's why they come in this very, very small and unusual bottle. But there are about three different types. But this is the one you want for this. It seems to work. That was purely hit on by accident, but it worked. I thought I'd give it a try because it melts this stuff. So I thought of blending this with the super glue, but I didn't need to in the end. I just used this. Well, I say I didn't need to. I still used this as a backup anyway and glued it in position. Okay, so that's that. So I just wrapped that white round the end of the barrel, wedged it in. That was that. Again, it's all down to measurement. When you're doing this, you must make sure that the chamber housing is sat inside that slide, because otherwise you might either move that slightly too far out, or it'll be too far in, so that when this comes forward, when the slide comes forward and smacks into the back of the compensator, it'll blow it straight off. So it's all down to measurement. This one, as you can see, is a pretty good join. There's hardly any gap there at all, but there is a gap, literally a feather sized gaps, hardly anything at all, but it's enough to give it a bit of give, because you don't want that smacking into the front of, or the back end of the compensator every time. It will just eventually blow it straight off. So as I say, whilst you're gluing this, make sure that this is measured correctly. Same goes for the barrel length, although that doesn't really matter that much because it's buried inside the compensator itself, so it doesn't matter if you make the barrel slightly too long or whatever, as long as it isn't too short. So you have to add in a sleeve. So there's no real set length for that sleeve. I believe the sleeve length, for you that are in metric, is roughly 14 to 13 millimetres. Or for those of us in the old Imperial, it's about half an inch, maybe just over half an inch. For the sleeve, that is, in there. So that's it, really. The compensator, I've still got a lot of work on this. Oh, yes, I will tell you, though. The inner guide rod plug is another 5.1 guide rod plug. All that I've done is ground off the rear lip, which is that. I've ground that off so that it will slide through either way. Reason being, as I said earlier, in order to make these 5.1s longer to fit inside the slide apron of a 1911 slide, you need to get rid of that lip. And it's dead on, the exact same length. Now then, the reason why I've done that is to fill that so that all of this front end looks, the holes, everything, will be looking flush. That's why I'm going to use the MMD filler on it. So all the little holes, gaps, whatever, will be flush. The back doesn't matter so much, but the front does. So that will, I may fill the back as well eventually. But yeah, so that was put in there just purely so that the guide rod goes into something quite nice and snug. Now then, I've also sleeved it. You don't have to do this, but I've done it for a little bit more stability. So I've actually knocked inside the back end part, i.e. this part of the guide rod housing, because the front part is slightly smaller hold, a piece of copper tubing. It's microbore tubing, i.e. pipe, which is, funnily enough, the exact same inner dimension for the guide rod plug. So I've hammered that in there. Eventually there'll be two pins. I was thinking about using grub screws, but now with regards to the guide rod, I don't have to worry. So I'm now going to glue and pin, or super glue and pin, two pins in there to make sure that that doesn't move, i.e. slide in and out. Then it'll all be filled. Oh, and another thing is this hole at the front, that barrel obviously only comes to about halfway up this front compensator. Now you could leave it like that if you wanted and have a huge hole at the front, but looking on the films and so forth, frame grabs that I've done of this particular pistol, the hole at the front is pretty much the same diameter as a standard barrel hole for a 45mm gun. So how do I get over this, because the front of the slide is a lot bigger, as you can see. So luckily enough for me, I had an old 4.3 black plastic barrel knocking about in my spares box, glued it in position, cut it down obviously so it didn't interfere with the barrel at the back, cut it down, glued it in with super glue, sleeved it again using the where is it, the plastic sleeve around there. So I just sleeved it again, wedged it in, and it stays in position. You can see the sleeve actually just underneath the barrel there. I don't know if you can quite make it out, but it's the sleeve going around it. That just makes sure that it's wedged in fully and safe, so it's not going to fly out. There's no pressure on that, so it's not going to be hit by anything, because the barrel that's inside only comes, it's a standard barrel actually, so it only comes to the just inboard of the end of that barrel there. So it's not going to, it's got a slightly extended barrel, but not a lot. So it's not going to hit this front end and blow it out. So yeah, so that was that. So I glued that in. As I say, eventually this will all be filled with that MMD filler. This will be pinned and glued in, the guide rod plug. I may even consider doing that with a barrel as well, by putting two pins in as well, just to be on the safe side. But to be quite honest, I don't think that's going to go anywhere. It's quite tough. And of course, I've already marked out roughly where the compensator holes are going to go, where the ports are going to go, the ejection ports for the gas on the top of the compensator. Now I've got to drill those first into this inner barrel, or outer inner barrel, whatever you want to call it. I've got to drill right through, because otherwise it's defeating the object. If you just cut down there and have them exactly the same sort of height or whatever as they should be in the film, they're hardly going to go through that barrel at all. So you'll have no hole there, it will just be the inside of that barrel. We don't want that, so I'm going to drill down through, make holes into it, then cut it out and then file it, which will be in the next video. I'll show you the result of that. As I say, so that will be the ports that will go in there. But that's it really, that is the basics of it. It was tricky to work out, and I'm just hoping, fingers crossed and praying, that when this all goes together, my measurements, which are mainly by eye, work out, and this doesn't hit too harsh against the slide. It shouldn't do. As I say, I allowed a thin gap in between the compensator and the slide, so it should work okay. This is all part of gunsmithery, is working all this out, because if it goes wrong and smacks into it, then the gun's no good. It won't work properly and it will malfunction. So yes, hopefully, as I say, this will all work. The parts are pretty much all here. I've got them all assembled and ready to go. It's unfortunate I couldn't use my own homemade guide rod like I did in the Mark for Death pistol. But never mind, this will get used on another project. So always handy to have. With regards to the other guide rod, that's going to now come in handy. As I say, I've got to drill two other holes in there to make sure that it will work. But other than that, there's the majority of the parts, or the main parts, so far. So stay tuned for the next part, which will hopefully have all of the bits assembled and hopefully working. Maybe not painted, maybe not filled, but hopefully will be working. So you'll be able to see that it all functions okay. Hopefully. Fingers crossed. So stay with me, or stay tuned, I should say, for the next instalment of the replica that I'm making, custom build of the Punisher 1911 from the 2004 film, because I believe there's been another film before that with Rutger Hauer in it, I think it was. Not Rutger Hauer, can't think of his name. Anyway, there's another guy who starred in the film previously. I think it was about 1989, I think that film was. But this one is the 2004 film. Okay, so I'm going to stop mumbling and say this is LaZouche Custom Shop signing off.